Hello everyone, I'm Zishan and today we are going to see how to animate a waterfall in 3ds Max using the particle system. I will try to explain to you step by step of what I'm doing. It would be very easy for you to follow, just follow my steps. And at first I'll be creating the creek of the mountain and then I'll be going into the water particle. So let's start. Enter into perspective view with Alt W and select box. And drag your mouse to create a box. That's fine. And let's change the length to 60 and width to 40. And let's change the height. Let it be 30. Yeah. Let it be 30. Yes, that's fine. And now come into front view. Click F in your keyboard. And now select cylinder and drag your mouse to create a cylinder. Yes, that's fine. And come into perspective view with P in your keyboard. And now let's make the cylinder a little longer. Yes, that's fine. And make sure the cylinder is longer than the box. Yes, that's fine. Let it be the river of the creek. Yes, that's fine. And a little lower. Yes, that's fine. Okay, now select this box and then from standard primitives come to compound objects. Yes, and then there select boolean and make sure you are given move and pick operand B. Yes, and now select the cylinder. As you can see, the cylinder is gone along with it has also cut at the it also cut the box. Yes, that's fine. And come into top view with T in your keyboard and from compound objects come back to standard primitives. In standard primitives choose plane and now drag your mouse to create a plane. Yes, that's fine. And now come into perspective view with P in your keyboard and let's make it higher. Yes, that's fine. And come into top view again, T in your keyboard and yes, drag the mouse to create a plane. And now come again to perspective view and as you can see just move it around as you wish. Now come into front view again, press F in your keyboard and then now create a plane. Yes, that's fine. Now come into perspective view and move this around here. Yes, that's fine. Now let's give this plane some color. So I mean the water color. So just follow my steps. Click M in your keyboard. You'll be shown to this tab. And now let's select this box over here. And let's change the color. Select this gray box, the color box. And let's change over here. Red to I think 5. Green to let's make it 161 and blue to 88. And now yes, that's fine. Now over here diffuse, let's change the diffuse color, red to let's make it 99 and I think green to 161 and B to 141. Yes, that's fine. And then come over here to extended parameters. Plus this, click this plus sign, and over here come to this box, and then let's change year two, from red 128 to 0, green to around 121, and blue to let's make it 71. Yes, that's fine. This color is fine for now. Now let's make it. Let's change the. Let's give it some map. So to give it some map, you'll have to come over here. Just come over here to maps. Click this sign and near bump. Take it and then make sure it's 30. And now in instead of none, select it and choose noise over here. Yeah, okay. And you will be shown over here. Just let's make it a little tiling to the x tiling to 3 and the size to 30 and turbulence. Yeah, that's fine. And now let's give it let's give this planes the map. So select these three planes over here, the three planes, and select this box over here. Yeah, that's fine. Now you can give if you render, you can see this shape. Yeah, as you can see, it gives a little bit of a water shape. It's not perfect, but for now it's okay for us to for me to show you the waterfall. Yes, that's fine. Okay, now let's make the waterfall, the particles. Now it's time to give the river some motion. We are going to use a particle here. I'm going to use the spray particle. To create the spray particle, go from standard primitives to particle system. In the particle system, select spray and come to front view. In the front view, drag your mouse to create a spray particle. Yes, that's fine. Now let's change the width. Let's change the width to around 12 point, I think 5 would be fine. Yeah, and length to, let's make it smaller. Yeah, that's fine. And let's move it higher over here. I think we could change the length too. So come over here again and scroll down to see length, and I'll just make it smaller. Yeah, something around 1.2 would be fine. Yeah, and come to perspective view with P and lower it down around here and move it back. Yes, that's fine. Now let's give the this particle a map. We'll give the same map as we gave to the planes. So just click M in your keyboard and select this over here, assign material to selection. Make sure you selected the spray. And yeah, select it, and the color of these particles would have changed now. Okay, now let's change the settings over here now. Let me explain to you what these settings are. But before that, I'll show you the motion. Yes, that's you can see some particles coming out of the spray. Yes, that's it. Okay, yeah, and now let me show you what these options are. Viewport count is the amount you could see, amount of particles you could see in the viewport. This is we could see 100 particles now. If we just reduce it, you can see there aren't a lot of particles. That's viewport count, and render count is the particles you could see when you render. To render, just click F9. As you can see, there are particles you could see in the render mode. Now let's change the particle amount. So let's change from render count 100 to I think 500 would be fine. Yeah, and render again to see there are other particles around. Now let's yeah, that's fine. And let's change the drop size to 3. Drop size is it's the size of the particle. And now click F9. You could see the particles are a little bigger now. Yeah, that's fine for now. We don't need the spray part direction over here. We'll need that in the direction of the waterfall. So let's rotate it. Select the rotate and rotate tool, and from 0 in Z axis to 180. Yes, that's fine. It's longer now, so let's change it. To change it, change the speed now. Speed to 5 would be fine. Yes, that's fine for now. You see the particles are moving. Yes, that's fine. And just change it. You can see the difference now. Tetrahedron. You could see the particles a little pointed and facing. It's different. You don't need it facing, but we could also give it facing. It would be fine too. Now I'll be giving it facing for now. Okay, that's fine. And we are given the map too. So now we can duplicate the spray. Now click shift in your keyboard and drag the mouse. Yes, that's fine. And come to left view with L in your keyboard. And place this over here near the plane, the third plane we have created. Yes, that's fine. And yeah, okay. Now let's make this a little longer. Width to something around this would be fine, and we can change this plane too. So select this select and uniform scale, that is the scaling tool, yeah, and change it to something around, yeah, that would be fine. Yes, that's it. And we have created the water motion. You can render and see it too. You can see the water motion. Now let's make the waterfall. To make the waterfall, you'll have to use the snow particle. Snow particle is just like the spray particle, but it's a little bit different. So let's just create the snow particle for now. Come over here to create tab, and in the particle systems, you'll be seeing the snow over here. Select snow and come to top view, and just drag your mouse to create a particle. Yes, that's fine. And now let's come to perspective view and click select this move tool, and let's move it over around here in the top. Yeah, that's fine. Now let's change the settings of the this particle. Viewport count to 100, but it doesn't matter. And render count to, let's make it 1000. Flake size to 2. Speed to, let's make it 4. Yeah. I think 4 would be fine. And variations to, yeah, 2 would be fine. Or we could make it 1, 2, yeah. And number, yeah, and make sure you're changing it to facing. Yeah, that's good. And you can render it now. You can see this thing like this for now. So let's change the color. Click M in your keyboard, press M in your keyboard, and assign this material to the snow. And you can see it somewhat resembles a waterfall. And now we are going to give it some deflectors and all, so it will be fine later. So now let's change the timing. Start, let's make it to -200 and left to 30. And width, it's all the same. It doesn't matter for now. Yeah, that's fine. Now you can see that the water is going down instead of bouncing off. So we are going to give the bouncing effect. To give the bouncing effect, we are going to create a deflector. It's a particle too, which kind of deflects the other particles. So which gives the bouncing effect to the particles. So let's just go to the create tab over here. Go to the create tab, and come over here to space warps. Select space warps and click over here and select deflectors. In deflectors, select deflector. Now come to top view and drag your mouse to create a deflector. Yes, that's fine. Okay, and come to perspective view. Yeah, that's fine. Now we will have to warp this two particles. I mean, link them, so that the particle falling from the snow would be bouncing from the deflector. So we'll have to be linking these two. So select this deflector and come over here to bind to space warp. This is the tool which connects which links two particles. So select this thing and just drag select from this, drag it to the snow particle. That's fine. Now the particles are going to bounce off rather than going down. So as you can see, some particles are bouncing. You see, it would be bouncing now, yeah, like that. So now come over here. Let's change the parameters of the deflector to. Let's change the parameters. So bounce to let's make it 0.4. We don't need it. We don't need it more than 1. Or 0.5. Let's change the chaos to 75. Yeah, and yes, that's it. Now you can render it. It would be fine now. We can make even a AVI file to see the progression of the water from there to here. So I'll show you how to make the AVI file too. Come over here to rendering in the select render setup, and over here come over select range 0.0 to 100. Yes, that's fine. And come over here to select where you'll be saving the file. I'll just save it in my desktop. Yes, that's fine. Fold and save. You'll have to be selecting AVI file over here and save. Okay. And then just give it render. Yes, that's fine. So we'll be watching the AVI film, yeah, the waterfall, and yes, as you can see, the water is flowing. Let's rewatch it. As you can see, the water is flowing, and the water is flowing down there too. Yes, that's it. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe and comment down below for any questions. Thank you.